Hello, everybody. I'll give everyone a moment to join, make sure everything's connected, make sure everyone's here. Looks like we are. All right, guys. Thank you so much for spending some time with me today. I still have to do our one card read for tomorrow, but I wanted to show up a little bit early just so that we could basically put our finger on the pulse of these three celestial events. There's a lot of things going on. And before I started today, I sort of said, what's the vibe? What's going on? Energetically, by the way, I feel great, but I got the anticipation or the sort of nervousness of some of you with the Devil card. I pulled it again and I got the Three of Wands. So one of the things that I'd like to encourage everyone to think about is that especially as we are combining a new moon with all of this, this is a time for manifestation. Thoughts manifest. So you can manifest hopes. You can also manifest fears. Let's choose to manifest goals and hopes and dreams. If we have a fear, it can inform our next move of what to do to educate or to prepare ourselves, but let's not get too far ahead of ourselves. That's the main thing that I picked up on so far. Because there's three different events, I'm gonna pull cards for each of them, and then we're gonna take a pulse check on the elements, basically breaking down and looking at the signs. So I think I would like to start first with the new moon, because it is about opportunities. Then we'll look at the eclipse for revealing things, and then we'll look at what we can let go of. Okay? I'm gonna do it in the order of what I wrote above. Good to see everybody. Glad to see you're here. It looks like most of you are interested in the interplay between the three. I'll leave that poll up for a little bit, and we'll see what's going on here. Okay? So, yes, I know it is a solar eclipse. I think I put that in there, so, yep. All right, let's go ahead now and get started. Let me just zoom in here. We're gonna start with the new moon and see what energy is coming through for that. And then we'll move along to the solar eclipse. Okay. We're going to look at past, present, and future influences with this new moon and see what's going on here. All right, so as we look into the deep past, what I'm picking up on here is really about reclaiming balance here. So we have the beautiful Six of Pentacles, and the Six of Pentacles is a card that reminds you that you have more than enough, provided that you're realistic, provided that you're unafraid to sort of say, yeah, I can do this, but this is a little overwhelming. Or in order for me to do this, I need a little bit of this. Basically, negotiation, boundaries, using that word no, which we're sometimes afraid of, and then being realistic with things. Thinking of when you're a child, it's hard to kind of grasp the Six of Pentacles because you want everything now. As an adult, you realize if I can still have everything and it just means I wait a little bit longer or I accept a little bit more help, it's basically compromising a bit to get what you need. As long as you're willing to do that, you can achieve what you're trying to achieve. And that's a really positive message. But it is a message of patience and boundaries and realistic sort of expectations. Okay? So that's the first element. And some of you may be challenged with that, especially saying no or waiting. So let's go ahead and see what the present opportunities represent here. What I love here is if you're feeling like I want this faster or I need this now, or, you know, I feel like there should be more coming in, the answer really lies in partnerships. It's hard for some of you maybe to go there because in the past someone didn't come through. I don't necessarily see that being in the present so much. But let's look at these two cards close up. So one of the things that you can do is ask for help. You could say, hey, what do you think? I could use some assistance here. Or you can lean on someone and say, I really would just like to talk. You're not alone. That's basically what this card is saying. So one of the ways that you can bring goals to fruition much quicker is simply by letting other people help, listen, assist, or even enrich what you're working on, partnership in general here. In the past, though, because this is underneath it, it feels like some of you may have dealt with people that said they were going to be there, that they were going to support you, but that didn't come through, and that makes you a little bit resistant to reach out again. And I don't blame you. That's just sort of like self-preservation. But one of the things that you can manifest since we're in a new moon is use mantra. I think for today's card, I put a mantra at the end. You could say, I've learned my lessons from the past. I'm ready to receive partnerships that are on the same level as me. And then just make sure that you're doing everything to be accountable, to be communicative, to be honest, to be realistic. If you can embody those, then you can attract those. And that's the message here. And if there's someone who just won't listen, they're not the right mix. You're going to find the person that's on the level. This, as I always say, a rejection or some sort of friction when you're trying to communicate, listen to that. As I was working with one of my my co-producer, we're trying to get a podcast here started over the summer, and we were looking at a place, they canceled on us, and I'm like, that's not the place. We're not going to even try a second time because our schedules are too important and we're right on the heels of a retrograde. That place dropped the ball. We're not going to go there. Sometimes if it's too hard or you're too busy and something closes, I'm really observant of that. I'm like, that. Thank you, universe. I'm not going to waste my time with looking at that location. It's a miss. So don't push it. Don't force it. That would be my advice here when it comes to partnerships and communication overall, especially during a retrograde. If it fits, it fits. If it doesn't, go where the energy is. Okay. It's all about moving the needle forward, folks. You are going to start to see movement. We've got partnership bookended by two sixes. One six is going to bring you balance and abundance. One is going to bring you movement. And there could have been delays in the past. There could have been resistance for action for you. And we notice in this Six of Swords, it's just one person. There is usually in this card a passenger, a person rowing the boat, sometimes a third party. In this one, it's just you. You're the one that's going to bring things forward, initiate a conversation, initiate travel, whatever it is that you need to do. It kind of sits in your lap here. So that's exciting, but it does require some movement on your part. And I think the resistance here, once you can get past the resistance, the movement naturally happens. So for those of you who just joined, welcome. We're going to be looking again here at new moon opportunities. So the biggest opportunity is to reclaim balance, to invite some partnership energy in, not to fight it if someone isn't interested or isn't listening, they're not the match. Keep working on yourself, keep working on what you're trying to do, because it feels like it's already on some levels moving forward. Just like a Three of Wands reverse, this doesn't mean that it's not happening. It could mean that there's subtle movement, that the minute you get started, you make up for lost time, or that if you don't get started soon, you're gonna have some catch up to do. So I see the wheels already turning. It's just really about finding the right partnership and finding the right balance. Really auspicious for the new moon overall. We're gonna now move on to the next piece. So this was new moon. Now we're gonna look at the solar eclipse. This is about manifesting. Eclipses are typically about revealing things to us. Let me move into a different deck while we're doing that. Mr. Apollo's taken a midday nap. Isn't that the life to live in the background? In case anyone was wondering, where's the dog? He's right back there. All right, let's see. I think I'll use the little Prince deck because there are moons on it, so it seems like it's calling to me. All right, so let's take a look at this solar eclipse from a new moon, which is really cool. Never mind the fact that a retrograde is around the corner. What does the eclipse want to reveal to us? What is it that we're having a hard time seeing? Okay, all reversals, that's okay. We're gonna read them upright here and just see what the resistance might be. If it's three in a row, I really don't read it, all is reversed. Okay, we're gonna look at the magician first. So the first reveal is you are more powerful than you think. You are already in the flow of energetic creation. But since all of these came through reverse, there is doubt of power or doubt of intuition, or sometimes not allowing yourself just to do what feels right. Trust your gut, have some fun, roll up your sleeves, get some work done. This is a very hands-on card. The magician is the beginning. The fool is the very beginning, but the magician's where the magic starts to happen. And one of the things that makes it powerful is discernment. So we can actually take these two cards together. This is deciding how much, how often, and when. And this is then saying, all right, let's do it. I like to liken the magician to like a chef. So if you put everything into like a soup, it's not going to taste good. You don't want to put all the spices, all the vegetables. It's what you don't include. It's how much you do include. It's the choices you make where the power and the magic really happens. So that's really where the power is right now. First of all, you have power, and then you also have choices, and those choices are what make you an important part of that decision. Focus. If I could give you one thing to do, to just like you're saying, thank you, Nicholas, but how do I apply this to my life? It's about focusing on one thing and making that be the thing that you really try to bring progress or movement or healing to in any given day during this period of retrograde, during this this eclipse, and during this new moon. The new moon can really take us to the next sort of a lunar reading that I do, so at least a couple of weeks. All right, so let's go ahead and see what's affecting you in the moment. Well, hello. I mean, the card actually did come through reverse, which means an unveiling. But not everything is going to be in black and white. This is one of the things that's interesting with spirituality, with creativity, and with intuition. Sometimes we do feel like we're walking into uncharted territory. It's not all been laid out for you. Intuition gives you a compass, gives you a feeling, gives you hope. But it is up to you then to do something with the intuition. Intuition, like any of the ace cards, is only as valuable as the application of your sort of next step. So I would say the onus is on you now to decide what I'm doing, what you're going to do may not already be out there. You might be inventing something new. You might be trying something that your friends, family, or loved ones don't understand. But this is you kind of going out there and saying, I believe in myself. I have the power. I have the capability. I have the capacity to do it. It may be uncharted territory, but that's exactly what makes research and development, exploration, space, if you're traveling out into space or something, anytime we're doing something that hasn't been done, that's what that is. So in short, you have abilities that you may not have tapped into, and you're being asked to use those in unproven, uncharted, or unexplored applications. So this is a time to research and develop something new about yourself. And you may not have a guarantee on that, but if it feels right, that's all you really need in this moment in time, okay? Where's it taking you? Well, some of you are deciding to write something down or create something tangible with it. The Page of Swords is a pretty active card. I love this illustration. This captures what's in the Rider-Waite-Smith deck. So in the traditional Page of Swords, we'll see the page holding a sword here and looking over their shoulder, kind of cocking there in the background and looking and listening. So this is getting it. The page is tuning in. So first and foremost, listen to what people have to say, see what's going on. Your research can help you get through the block. Your research can help inform the development. And again, you don't have to be working in a company to apply research and development. This can be a decision of like, what do I want to work on for myself? How can I do better in this relationship? How can I improve my health or whatever? But right now, if you read up and talk to and engage with other people and listen to their successes, their challenges, their sort of obstacles, you're going to learn from that and save some time. So talking, yes, but listening is even more powerful. And this page really beautifully captures that. So I love that. If you happen to be creative and you want to write something down, whether it's a proposal for work, whether it's something creative like a writer, it could also be something academic like a journal, or it can even be something that you're going to, like a curriculum, something that you're teaching. The writing, we use that for so many different things, but the main thing that I see you doing is getting something done and feeling like, wow, it's out on paper. Now it's one step closer to being completed. And that is a great way to manifest, by the way. I have a presentation I have to give next week for somebody. And today we just went through the outline. Before I got started on creating something else, I wanted to just make sure that the flow of thoughts was there. And it was, and it was that helped inform some of the next steps. So sometimes just putting it on paper, it was like, oh, good, I think we're ready for this. Now I just have to kind of like do a little bit of background work. But it's you're further along than you think if you can just write it down and see it. And maybe that's part of it. it's just a matter of you putting it into the world. It's not there yet, but that doesn't mean it can't be. Everything that we see up to the light bulb behind me at some point had to be invented, you know? So you're in that sort of aha or light bulb moment. I had a fun sort of reading last week where the power went out. And as I was talking about that, the light bulb came on. So maybe this is a moment for a figurative or maybe a literal moment where something breaks through like that. All right, I'm going to try to keep all these cards on the table. And now we're going to move on to the energy of retrograde. And we're really trying to make sure that you can make the most of all of these things. So let me use a different deck for this. Ah, yes. I'm going to use this black and white deck because it can show light and shadow, which we kind of need for a retrograde. So we just did the new moon, and then the solar eclipse, and now we're going to look at retrograde and how it affects all of us. Okay, past, present, and future. Interesting cards. All right, so in the past, we have indecision being one of the challenging things. Seven of Cups. Let's take a look at this up close. It's actually auspicious when this card is reversed. Look at how cool this illustration is. Your head's in the clouds. Typically, the Seven of Cups shows all the clouds floating in the air. The person either being inspired or overwhelmed with all of the sort of options in front of them. In this one, the person's gone so far into that zone of what if or how about this or questions and thoughts that they need to come back down to earth. So the reversal of this would actually show that you would probably be grounding yourself and deciding, I'm going to do this. So in this retrograde, one of the things is it's important to ask questions, but don't go so far down a rabbit hole that you start to doubt yourself, doubt others, or create chaotic situations. Ask an informed and specific question, and once you get your answer, you can move on to the next thing. Just don't go overboard with that. When it comes to the research that I talked about earlier, look at a few things. Usually three is good, you know, power of three on this. So two or three options, pick the best in front of you. It's basically about reining things in. So that's one of the lessons from the past, could be just reining it in and not overextending. This is also about sort of being distracted or being kind of obsessed over a certain thought. And this is about releasing some of that distraction and focusing. A common thread is finding balance, having limits, being focused, and that focus and clarity really will help everything come together. What's the opportunity right here, right now, as you're tuning in? You are very close to completion. I love the Nine of Wands. This is an interesting Nine of Wands because the person is feeling just a little bit beaten down. Let's look at the traditional one because this is giving Nine of Wands a bad rap. And Nine of Wands is a great card. What happens on the Nine of Wands is burnout, exhaustion, uncertainty, fear, and doubt. But what it also represents is perseverance, success on the horizon, and just a little necessary push. So here's your slightly more light-oriented Nine of Wands where the person's saying, you know what, I've worked really hard. Nothing's going to get me down. When I use the Light Seer's deck, she isn't even bothered. She has no sort of like blemishes or anything. She's just standing there saying, I'm going to finish this. So we're somewhere between those today. This person is saying, I want to finish. I've worked hard. This person is saying, I'll finish, but I need a self-care day. So it feels like some of you need a mini vacation. You might need to take care of your health. You might need to really just get a little bit of rest. And I wanted to do this reading, but I had some work to do in the morning, and I wanted to do it when my energy was right. So I could have done it at 9 a.m., but I wasn't ready. So I would say for you, you have to eventually get something done, but give yourself enough time to do it when you're ready. So a little rest. You may not get the full 1 week vacation. Maybe it's a 1 day. Maybe it's 2 or 3 hours. A little bit of rest, a little bit of focusing, and then finish what you started. You'll be okay. Nine of Wands can also show headaches, stress headaches, caffeine headaches, the distraction that we were talking about here. So meditation, sleep, and diet and exercise. All of those things are going to help kind of turn your mental energy into the right space. If you need more help than that, then get more help, obviously. Okay, Now we have the Nine of Swords, the fear-based card here in the future. Everything was good. Then retrograde comes in and it's sort of like, I'm gonna shake things up a little bit, but we're okay with retrograde. Nine of Swords is never as bad as it feels. It's a lot of the same energy of what we just talked about. The nines carry with them fatigue. So what she's worrying about here is worst case scenarios. A lot of times this comes because you're burning the candle at both ends. You're not getting enough rest. One of the easiest ways to solve this is simply to make sure that you go to bed roughly the same time. It doesn't have to be like on the dot. So if you normally have a 10 o'clock time of, you know, like when you go to sleep, it could be 9:30, it could be 10, it could be 11:30, but there shouldn't be any 1 or 2 or 3 a.m. things. Like within half an hour of your normal sleep cycle, make sure that you're getting to bed. Before you go to bed, no caffeine. Put your phone, if you're going to use your phone at all, put it into that sort of sepia tone, whatever that's called, and try not to bring it to bed. Try to put it by the, you know, I would say 30 minutes of cleansing before you go to bed. Like no iPad, no phone, no TV, just kind of, you can listen to some music, or if you have the television on in the background, try to dim it, try to keep the volume down. You really want to get the distractions out. And if you can get out of that habit of watching TV and falling to sleep, it's a lot better because you don't know what they're pumping through the commercials and all that stuff. You don't want that going into your head before you go to bed. So controlling the environment around you will be really important. And then when it comes to fear and anxiety, I'm getting better. I've gotten a lot better. When I was a kid, I used to worry. As an adult, my body just says, go to sleep. We'll deal with it in the morning. And I know that I can deal with it. There's a trust in myself that if I can get X amount of sleep, I'll have a fresh perspective in the morning. This version of me, it needs to retire. I need to regenerate and have like a rebirth in the morning and look at it from a new set of eyes because this one's expiring for the day. And that's kind of how I view it. It's like every day is a new judgment card and I can rise up and it's a fresh perspective. View it like that and I think you'll be okay. But take care of sleep and mental health. It's super important. And those are the themes that are coming through retrograde. And for mental health, there's some that you can control. There's some where you're going to have to ask, you know, other people in your life for assistance and advice, and definitely lean on others if you need to. Let's pull an extra card. Let's go a little deeper in the retrograde for a second. And then I'm going to actually feel like that's the one that I want to expand the most, but I'm going to pull expanded cards quickly. We'll look at health, wealth, love, and destiny, and then I'll pull some things on the elements, and then we'll wrap up. I like to keep these a little bit shorter. So I think I'm going to just clear the cards now and put them to the side, and we're going to take a look here at health, wealth, love, and destiny during this sort of trifecta of three celestial events. What can we do to be our best during this period? All right, let's see. So let's take a look at the expanded forecast, but in this very special circumstance. Health, wealth, love, did we get two love cards? We did. All right, let's see what the second one was. I'm curious. Okay. And destiny. All right, let's break these down. Again, I'm doing very kind of in the flow reading tonight, but we're looking at health, wealth, love, and destiny. We're going to start off with the health message. And your health message is about regaining or retaining the sort of hopeful energy. I love how empowered this card is. Hope is one of the strongest sort of things that you can have to push you through, to help you kind of find a way, even when things seem to be beating you down like that. Nine of Wands a little bit energetically, if you're feeling tired, wake up in the morning and think, what is it that I'm most hopeful, excited, or engaged with that I hope to see some progress with? Reconnecting with that is going to help you in being healthier and happier. And if you've lost that sort of connection with something, it could be any aspect of your life, like work, for instance. If you're like losing hope that that's going to improve, shift direction, go where the energy is. If you're constantly getting pushed energetically from one thing, redirect where you're not? Where are the welcome arms? Where can you sort of just connect easier? That's where you want to go. Wherever you feel more hopeful, engaged, or optimistic. And this is a period where you want to really kindle and embrace and build that up a little bit. Okay, let's see what is going on with wealth and career. And for those of you that are students or retired, this can just be what you're spending your time and energy on. So I chose Lord Ganesh. Ganesha can help us see any positive energy, no matter what the block. So some of you are feeling that you're not sustained, you're not getting what you need. This could almost be a Seven of Pentacles in reverse, because we got the Seven, and he's got all this abundance around him. And if you aren't sustained, you're lacking the support that you would get in the Seven of Pentacles. Seven of Pentacles comes on the heel of what we talked about earlier, on the heels of the Six of Pentacles, when that balance is there. And you can go one direction or the other. You can either get more, or you can skip backwards to the Five, and we don't really want that. So I think what's important here is to feel like you're getting enough. You're getting enough support. There's enough room to grow. You know, certain pots need to be, like plants need to be replanted so that there's enough room for that growth. So if you're working at a place where you've reached the top, you've reached the limit, if you reach out for help and it's not there, or if you're just not engaged, if you're busy and bored, any number of things, something's not sustaining you the way that it could be. There could also be untapped resources in your life. So reaching out, asking for help, that's going to be part of bringing it in, and that might get you to the Eight of Pentacles, okay? So see yourself already there, and I think it's really just about either acknowledging that you've outgrown this, or you could reach out to someone and increase the flow. So if you don't get a yes, if you can't make the connection, it might be time to look in a different direction. And ultimately, sustenance is not just cash. It also, it constitutes passion, joy, hope, all the other things that are sort of intangible, non-material things. So are you sustained on multiple levels? The bank account is not everything. It's necessary because we live in a world where we have to pay for things, but it's not the end all be all. And you definitely can't take it with you. Let's take a look at love, where we got two cards coming through. Again, love can constitute all of these sections: romantic, platonic, friends and family. Let's just see what these are here. So the first card that came through is the Flamingo. Embrace the in-between. Some of you may be on the rebound. You may be fresh out of a relationship and you're like, I kind of like this. I don't really want to be in a relationship right now. Good for you. Some of you might be in the new phase, the honeymoon phase of a relationship, and you're like, are we in or are we out? What is this? Enjoy that. That's like Three of Cups energy. It's not about getting straight to the Ten of Pentacles or to judgment, and you're somewhere in between and you're enjoying making up your mind. Liminal spaces, in between spaces. That's what it's about with relationships. Feeling it out and deciding, like, first of all, having some fun with the in between and then deciding what you want next. Knowing that because it's a new moon, you're manifesting quicker. I talked about this in the daily card read for today, and I've noticed it this week. A passing thought, like, I kind of don't want to do this, then it results in a cancellation. Someone calls me and says, this time slot's not available, or I have to back out of this. And I'm like, I was just randomly thinking that, or it would be really cool if this happened. And then the same sort of thing happens. Openings and closings. So if you can just be open and open to the positive, you could manifest the positive. Have some fun. What's under the surface? The ability to change. So let's just look at this card in the upright position. This would be like death reversed. Some of you have been stagnating for a while. So I look at the chameleon spirit as being able to transform, which is very much like death and transformation. And of course, it is just sort of like, it is able to blend in. That's a really weird, that's a very colloquial thing, act as if. Act as if it is possible, or as if, like that old phrase that we used to say. I would say with this is a time to be bold. The opposite of the chameleon to me, like hermit, this is hermit reverse. It's saying, be bold. The chameleon can blend in, but really what you want to do is be bold as well. So if there's, and Flamingo's pretty bold. These are both bold totems to come through when it comes to love. So I think the important thing here is enjoy the in-between space. If there's something you want, go for it. If there's something that needs to change, this is the time to change it. This is what retrograde is good for, by the way. Anything that has RE, like revisit, review, reconstruct, anything where you're basically taking something and finishing it or fixing it or reviewing it or addressing it. Not necessarily starting new things if we're looking solely at the retrograde, but the cool thing with this is because the new moon is happening in combination with it, it's kind of muted the retrograde a bit. Same thing with the eclipse. We've got all three. So I do think in this retrograde, you can pepper in some new activities, especially if, here's where you can break the retrograde rule. If you're doing something to address an issue, like you think to yourself, I've been wanting to move, I'm tired of this place, I haven't taken action, then moving would be addressing something that hadn't been fixed and you're actually pulling something to a completion. So it's not that you can't do anything new. If you're doing something new and it's a reaction to something that hasn't been done for a while, then you're actually finishing something in retrograde. If you've always wanted to ask someone out, if you've always wanted to apply for that job, if you've always wanted to go the distance and see what would happen, then you're finally finishing a cycle, which is absolutely embraced with retrograde. Sprinkle in a little new moon and it's magic. So you can start some new things this time, especially if it's been on your bucket list. That's actually old news. That's old business and you're wrapping it up. So think a little broader. And remember that life doesn't stop for the planets. The planets can inform, they can direct, they can influence you, but you are an agent of your own discovery, an agent of your own creation, and you're making this happen too, okay? I always like to empower you. Don't be afraid of these events. That's why I'm doing a live today, because I'm feeling just fine and I hope you are too. All right, let's take a look now at destiny. This is ever-changing, and every time I do a reading, we're looking at something a little bit different, but let's see what the Destiny card is taking us to today. Contemplation. What do you want? Where are you at? That's really what this card is asking you. Some of you are just thinking and dreaming, and maybe for the first time in a while, imagining a different future. This is a beautiful card, isn't it? So this is saying, one of the great things you can do in any lunar event, full or new moon, is to sit down and get your head in the right direction. And so if you're gonna plant a seed, you need to know what the garden is gonna look like. You might have to clear some things out. You might need to get the right soil. You might have to get the right conditions to make something grow. So before you just boldly go in and start something new, again, a little bit of what you would do in a full moon will work in a new moon, which is to plan, to be clear, and then to take an informed decision. So think before moving. And then that Six of Pentacles that we talked about earlier, you're going to figure out where you can stretch, where you can pinch a little bit, what you're going to do with your time, energy, etc. Good stuff. There's nothing here that's difficult. These were good cards. The most interesting thing that I was picking up on was relationships. It feels like there's a desire to want to jump, but the card is saying, embrace this in-between phase first. And don't be afraid to be bold. And you have the ability to fit into any situation, even if it's not something that you would normally think is like you. This is a time to try on new things. All right, we're gonna take a look now at a quick elemental check-in, because I know whenever I do these, that's kind of helpful. So we're gonna look at fire, earth, air, and water. We'll make sure all the signs get a quick pulse here. So let me just see which cards call to me, and then we'll go from there. Going to be which cards are the closest here on this one. I like this deck too. All right, oops. We had a quick blip for a minute. Hopefully you can still see me. I'll keep an eye on the side while we're doing this. Yeah, it was just one moment. That was weird. There's our Mercury retrograde. Thank you for not losing me. I'll have to check connections after this. That was funny. All right, so we're going to look at fire, earth, air, and water. Fire, earth, air, and water. All right. So we're going to begin first with our fire signs. Knight of Cups in reverse. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. This is a time where emotionally you're feeling a little bit more charged, a little bit more sensitive. Give yourself the time, the space, and basically the self-care that you need to get things moving in the right direction. If we look a little closer at this card, it's beautiful. Look at how he's receiving the energy. It's as if the ace is coming towards him, and it's just a matter of receiving, which was a lot of what I was talking about in today's one card pull, saying I'm open to receive love, abundance, and opportunity, and I'm open to receive it now. But before you can be open to receive it, you also need to take care of yourself. So how are you feeling, mind, body, and spirit? What can you do to balance that out? Notice how he has sort of the mercurial hat there. Mercury usually has it on his, or Hermes has it on his heels, but I'm looking at that. So know this, your communication skills are kind of pretty powerful right now, and things can travel quickly. Make sure that when you're communicating, you're putting the best intentions out there and leading with positive energy in the heart. Compassion is really key here. Be strategic. I like that this knight is really being strategic. We see him almost on a chessboard. So this is a chance where you can get what your heart desires, but right now it feels like you need to take care of yourself. And maybe it's as simple as saying to yourself, I deserve to be happy. I'm ready for this because I've worked hard. Yes, I'm enough. This person or this place or this opportunity would be lucky to have me. So it's the Knight of Hearts as much as it's the Knight of Cups, because we can see he's wearing his heart on his sleeve, or he's wearing his heart right there. So it might be a little hard to put yourself out there, but that is one of the things, is being vulnerable. Okay, let's move on to Earth signs. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Believing in yourself. We hit on that a little bit already. Judgment. I talked about every day being the judgment card, right? You wake up every morning and it's about rising up and seeing yourself in a new space. So we have basically this little tiny kid representing the newborn that is each and every day. When judgment is reversed, what often happens here is there's this feeling of disbelief. So sometimes when someone says something out of left field, it may be completely in alignment for them, exactly what they need to do. But a lot of times it's sort of like, I didn't see that, or I can't believe that. Well, it's their life, it's their choice. And really what judgment reversed is saying is, I'm going to refrain from trying to, I don't need to control that. I don't need to judge that. I just have to decide what I want to do next. And so judgment is accepting what's going on and then deciding and empowering yourself to make the next move that's right for you. It's also saying second chances are possible. If you fail the first time, try again. If you're rejected at a job application, school application, or if you just did something and you think you can do better, you probably can. That each time is going to be a little bit better. That's why we keep coming back to this planet and reincarnating. It's so that we can improve, so that we can grow, so that we don't get tripped up by the same old, so that we become stronger, basically. And that's really what you have a chance to do. You can prove to yourself your own ability, and you'll surprise yourself. So be open to be pleasantly surprised. Don't judge yourself harshly. Don't really take others' harsh judgments to heart and kind of like let it go. And I think that's going to be key here. Suspend that need to judge or be judged. Accept, move forward, and see things now as a fresh start. Okay? Earth, you can do this. You have the ability. I mean, it's kind of, there's a seasonality with the earth element. Everything has a season and a reason. And this one is really saying it's time to restart. And so you get a chance to kind of reset more than any of the signs so far. And I think that's good. Okay, let's move from my earth signs to air. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Another note of self-care, we have the strength card here. The strength card in reverse is not just about taking care of your body, but let's start with that. So some of you may be taking on more than you need to, working too many shifts, helping too many people. There could be some just mental fatigue. Wherever it's at, remember that your body and your mind have limits, so honor that. The other thing with the strength card is, of course, a power struggle. So some of you may have a person in your life where you feel like there's this constant need to prove yourself, or you can get your way, but at such a great energetic cost that you ask yourself, why am I doing that? What I love about this empowered card is it doesn't exist. They're looking eye to eye. They're equals. There's no need for domination. There's no need for convincing. They're not putting words in each other's mouth. And this is the key. And because you guys are such great communicators, you don't have to,
you don't have to kind of throw your words in someone else's mouth. You want to make sure that you're being heard and seen for yourself, and let them do the same. If they want your help, they'll ask. And if they don't, that's their loss, because you guys have great diplomatic and communication skills. So save your energy. That's basically what this is saying. Save your energy and save your time. And only if someone's ready or willing to take it, whether it's a superior or it's someone that you're looking after, empower them to learn from their own mistakes. That's part of this as well. Okay. Overall, you might surprise yourself in a newfound voice or power that you didn't know that you had. It might come out and you're like, wow, where did that come from? It's always been there. And now it's just about owning that strength a little bit more. Okay. And now let's move on to Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces, all of my water signs. By the way, everything came through reverse. Not a big surprise. We're looking at retrograde. Yes, I shuffle the deck. Reversals help us see where the resistance is. So for you, it's basically about reclamation of control. And so boss energy is coming in really strong for all my water signs. This, notice also how we have this person taking sort of like focusing here. It is basically deciding targeting. This is what I want. So before you act, it was that informed decision, that informed research that's really important. Let people know where you stand, what you want, and don't be afraid to raise your hand or speak up. You are, you're someone that can make a difference. People are interested in what you have to say. Not only that, but this is also sort of energetically what this whole period is about, saying, you know what, we talked about this too. I have a place at the table. This came through for Libra. You've earned a place at the table. You've earned a voice at the table. But part of it is using that voice and speaking up and not letting other people sort of shut that down when it's important. This is kind of like a middle management card. So it doesn't mean like you have to be the boss of everyone and everything. It doesn't mean that you have to delegate things. It's just saying, I have a say, and using that say to kind of affect things in the right way. Maybe slow down a little bit if there's a lot of travel going on, and really just focus on planning. I'm looking at the strategy on this one and saying it's really important to know where you go, where you're putting your resources before you kind of pull the quiver or the trigger or whatever metaphor you want to use here. So that planning is going to save you time and it's going to cost you less in the long run. Okay. So that's everything, folks. I feel like that's good. I like to keep these shorter. I did go a little bit more verbose, but there were so many things. I knew it would be at least half an hour today, but I wanted to hit on all of the celestial events. We'll do a final card too, so that you can ask me a question. But I wanted to hit on all the celestial events and then also hit on all the signs here. Okay, so to that end, take a moment here, and we're not gonna meditate today because I like to keep these a little bit shorter. Take a moment and think about one thing that you'd like some direction or some advice on. And I'm going to shuffle the cards and we're going to look at a final card here. One card to sort of address the collective questions that you're sending my way. We love the King of Wands here. This is fantastic. So the King of Wands, surprise, surprise, was reversed. I love that he's riding a unicorn here. And I love the illustration on this as well. King and Queen of Wands are kind of magical. They can take a little and make it a lot. So this is nicely aligned with what we were seeing when we were looking at the new moon energy, the Six of Pentacles. You can take limited resources and really grow them. And this is something we can all relate to, especially if you're in the US and you just paid your taxes, you just saw your bank account shrink. And so it's sort of like, all right, I need to take a little of this, do a little bit of this. And the message here is make it work, find a way, move things around a little bit. The King of Wands is willing to look at things from a different perspective, to take the challenge and say, I've got this, I'll find a way, we'll make this work. It also is a very steadfast, slightly stubborn card, dare I say. So especially when it's reversed and it's not going to accept no for an answer. Now, this is, I mentioned earlier, pay attention to anything where the energy is not accepted. This is more like, I'm not going to let my dream die. I'm not going to let my voice be closed down. So I'm going to find a way to communicate. I'm going to find a way to do it. It doesn't mean that you have to do it just one way. It's not giving up on yourself. And that's a beautiful message, and that's a beautiful way to sort of close here. We have a couple more things I want to talk about before we do that. But with this, I would say the important thing here is ownership. The King of Wands isn't going to hand it off to someone else, isn't going to let someone else do it if it's important. He is going to take ownership and say, I care about this enough and believe about this enough that I'm going to stand behind it. I'll put my name behind it. So that's another message here as well. But you have the power and the wherewithal to do something. And even with limited resources, you can find a way. Okay? I hope you guys like this. If you did, remember, this is so important to subscribe. Not only can you chat, I try to make the subscriber-only chat, which means like you can have fun and talk to everybody here, but you'll also know that I'm doing this. So opt into the bell notification and select all. Make sure that you've subscribed, then you can be a part of all future collective readings here. Give me a follow on social media. I did tweet this and put it on Facebook and put it on the Instagram story. So if I do a surprise one, I try to let people know on the major social platforms. So please do that if you haven't already. Remember, by the way, I don't offer private readings. There's a lot of imposters out there. That's a great way to spot them. So if anyone direct messages you, it's not me. If you ever want to find out more about me, you can go to my website. For those that gave back, I want to say thank you. If it's your first time here, welcome. I do a lot of different videos. I do weekly, monthly, daily, and then these sort of celestial ones. And I've got some other things that I'm working on that I'll launch later this year. So keep an eye out. You can also join my newsletter for more information as well. But anyway, thanks and welcome to everybody. I hope you enjoyed this. Before I wrap up, I always like to say thanks to the newest members and the newest Super Chat members here as well. So give me a second to just pull up the screen and then we'll go from there. Hopefully everybody's feeling great today, by the way. I'm looking at the poll here and it feels like you guys are you're in a good spot. All right, so no new members today, so that's okay. Thank you to everybody who has joined. I appreciate you. Let's see if there are any super stickers. I think I saw a couple fly by. So yeah, we got about four. So I want to say thanks before we wrap up. So thank you to Laura for your initial contribution there, to Renita, to Lady, and to Pearl. You guys rock and you allow me to keep doing what I'm doing here. So I hope you're all having a great midweek and let's rock this retrograde new moon and solar eclipse. I can't remember the last time we had three in a row like this. It's kind of crazy. Hey, thanks, Miss Moses. I saw that as well. I appreciate that. I'm going to take Mr. Apollo here for a walk. Let me see if I can pull him up for a little bit of love before we wrap up today. I want to say hi to the collective, buddy. You go for a walk after this? Yeah, I know. He's like, Dad, it was nap time. What are we doing? All right. So lots of love from this little furry creature and I. We wish you all the best. Thanks for spending some time with me tonight in a time that I don't normally go live. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you guys again tomorrow and the next day, Thursday and Friday. You can set a reminder for the next two readings. I think we have like Scorpio and Sagittarius. I got to take a look here on my main page. Let's take a look before I wrap up so I'm telling you the right things. So the next two readings that are coming up are indeed Scorpio and Sagittarius. So you can set a reminder for those if you haven't already. And in the meantime, I'm going to take this guy for a walk and have some fun and some kisses from Apollo as well. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.